Let's check out five things to see at the Cleveland Museum of Natural History and give you just a glimpse of what's in store when you visit. Perkins Wildlife Center is a refuge for Ohio animals, and it has my attention right away when I see bobcats, foxes, and coyote running through tunnels over my head. Different animals take turns roaming through the suspended trailways as a way to get exercise. Kids can get exercise too in their own tunnels. Perkins is really well done. You can explore different Ohio habitats like swamp, forest, and wetlands. There are bald eagles and peregrine falcons. You can clearly see underwater at the river otter habitat. And there are educational enrichment programs that help you learn about Ohio's ecosystems. If you haven't been to the museum in a while, this is one of the coolest additions you'll see. All the animals have been rescued, so Perkins is a second chance for them. If you love dinosaurs as a kid, walking through the dinosaur fossil collection will bring it all back for you. At least that's my experience standing next to the T-Rex. It's really something to get a sense of the size of these prehistoric animals. Triceratops is here, a cool Allosaurus skeleton. Keep in mind some of the bones are actual fossils and others are cast. What's the biggest dinosaur here? Haplocanthosaurus. Make sure to ask a museum staff member how they found this fossil. Everything about the museum is telling the story of nature, and this room is one of the most interesting chapters in that story. The astronomers at the museum have some great experiences to offer. First, the planetarium, in my opinion, is the best in Northeast Ohio. That's because the 4K projectors and their powerful software can take you on a tour of outer space. You can see the star constellations, you can go through the rings of Saturn, you could see the surface of the moon or Mars. The digital atlas has millions of stars programmed into it. And on Wednesday evening, September through May, you can visit the Mueller Observatory and stargaze through their vintage Warner and Swayze telescope. And don't forget the Apollo 12 moon rock in the Wade Gallery. You can be a few inches away from a piece of the moon. If you ever took an anthropology or paleontology class, your textbook probably featured Lucy, a specimen of historical importance found by a Cleveland Museum of Natural History team. The fossil collection in the Human Origins Gallery is very robust, and it is safe to say that people from around the world have traveled to see it. And for the kids, the Smead Discovery Center is a special retreat with hands-on exhibits. From dusting pretend dinosaur bones to learning different animal calls, young people of all ages can spend a lot of time here. In the hallway outside, there's a display of all different types of beetles. See if your little one can find the Volkswagen beetle. I didn't even get a chance to show you Balto or the Wade Gallery of Gems and Jewels, not to mention a recurring event they put on called Think and Drink with the Extinct. If that piques your interest, check out the description of this video for more information.